Now let's consider resistors whose values can be adjusted or varied. When you want to adjust the light in a room or the volume on a stereo, you normally adjust a variable resistor. A variable resistor is also often called a control, since it controls brightness, volume, or speed. Another common name is potentiometer, related to the fact that most adjust potential. Here's an assortment of variable resistors, and here's the schematic symbol for them. The resistor symbol has an arrow added to indicate the variable function. So how does a variable resistor work? Imagine a curved strip of carbon with its two ends close to each other but not touching. Current would have to flow around the strip of carbon to get from one terminal to the other. The resistance between these two terminals is fixed by the amount of carbon in the strip. Now add a third terminal attached to a shaft with a movable contact that rubs against the carbon strip. If we number the terminals, number 2 is often called the wiper of the variable resistor. The distance between terminals 1 and 3 never varies, but the distance between 1 and 2, or between 2 and 3, can be varied by turning the shaft. If you rotate the shaft clockwise, the arm moves closer to terminal 3. The resistance between terminals 2 and 3 is reduced. At the same time, the resistance between 1 and 2 has increased. The opposite happens as the shaft is rotated counterclockwise. Let's connect this control in a circuit. The fixed terminals are in the main line of the circuit with an ammeter also in the circuit. We'll connect a voltmeter to the wiper and one to the fixed terminal. As you can see, rotating the shaft has no effect on the current flowing in the circuit, but the voltmeter shows that the voltage changes with the rotation. This type of variable resistor is known as a potentiometer, or POT, because it adjusts or divides the potential, the voltage, in a circuit. Such a circuit is often called a voltage divider, and will be covered in more depth in a later lesson. A typical application is the volume control on a stereo. The POT varies the sound voltage to be amplified and sent to the speakers. So far, we've shown the potentiometer as a device that works by rotation, because most are circular in construction. Keep in mind, though, that variable resistors can also be constructed as a straight strip, with a slider moving back and forth as the variable contact. If only one fixed terminal and the slider or wiper terminal are connected in a circuit, the voltage is not divided. What happens instead is that current flowing in the circuit is made to flow through more or less resistance. Such a device varies the current flowing in a circuit and is called a rheostat. A rheostat is a two-terminal variable resistor that varies current rather than potential. A good example of a rheostat in action is the control that adjusts the brightness of the dashboard lights in many cars. As the knob is turned counterclockwise, the current to the lights, shown as one lamp symbol in the diagram, has to flow through more resistance in the rheostat. This reduces the current flow to the lights, and they go dimmer.